another one is out. It's streaming this week. Actually, it's been streaming for a couple of weeks, called Fastest DeLorean 2. Now, this is funny. A lot of sequels, the first thing a lot of people say about sequels, well, should I have seen the first one? And in this one, the filmmaker actually says, yes, you have to have seen the first one. And we should say the filmmaker is Adam Contras. It's his second documentary, and he's a bit of a friend of ours. He's from Columbus, Ohio, but he lives in L.A., and the whole, both of these movies, parts one and two, are based around the fact that for years he's made his living renting out this tricked-out DeLorean that he has.
Right.
It's tricked out completely like the Time Machine in the Back to the Future films. So the first one is mainly the story of how he got the car, how it came to be, and then his quest to set the speed record for a DeLorean, to be the fastest DeLorean in the world. And then it leaves us with a couple of big cliffhangers. He's on the side of the road with the car in flames. And then also, also one of the things that drove the first film is this incredible bit of deception by his brother.
Right.
And his brother's a gearhead that helped him with the car. And then it takes this turn that you just can't believe. So then part two picks up with that. So it follows again how the effect that this car has had on his life and all the places it's taken him and his good friend Don Fullilove, who plays Mayor Goldie in the films. They're good friends, and Don is involved in this as well. So you get to see how that plays out, fixing the car, and then how maybe his relationship with his brother gets fixed. It's put together in a very stylish way, and also Adam has a great quality of, an endearing quality of the fact that he's kind of watching this with us, looking back on it, and just saying to us, can you believe this? Can you believe all this stuff that's happening? And it really draws you in. So obviously it's going to be of interest to Back to the Future fans, gearheads as well. There's a lot of technical stuff about this car, what goes wrong, and how to fix it. But beyond both of those things, it's just an enjoyable story. And it's streaming now, Fastest DeLorean Part 2, along with Part 1.